hurt is freedom, purchased by the highest price. This grace outweighing all my shame. And I'm made new through the power of sacrifice. From death and now raised to life again. Hey. Oh my God, you're so good. You never give up. You never give up on me. Oh, what joy I find because of your love. Because of your love for me. Oh my God, so good. You never give up. You never give up on me. Oh, what joy I found because of your love. Because of your love for me. I'm not a slave to sin, you are good. There we were, Christ, to rise in your freedom. You are good. You make a promise, Jesus, you keep it. You are good. I'll praise your name as long as I'm breathing. Cause you're good. I'm not a slave to sin, so I'm singing. You are good. Baby, with Christ arising, your freedom, you are good. As you make a promise, Jesus, you keep it. You are good. So I praise your name as long as I'm breathing. Cause I'm good. Oh my God, you're so good. You never give up. You never give up on me. Oh, what joy I found because of your love. Oh my God, so you're so good.
Never give up on me.
Oh, what joy I found
because of your love. Because of your love for me.
Oh my God,
so good. You never give up. You never give up on me.
Oh, what joy I found
because of your love. Because of your love for me.
Oh my God, so good. You never give up. Never give up on me. Oh, what joy I found
because of your love. Because of your love for me.
I'm not a slave to sin, so I'm singing. You are good. I was buried with Christ to rise in your freedom. Because you're good. But you make a promise, Jesus, you keep it. You are good. So I'll praise your name as long as I'm breathing. You are good.
Testing. Well, good evening and welcome to Word Alive Church in Elwood City, right? We're glad to be here tonight and we believe we're going to be blessed and be a blessing as well. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, right? And his courts with praise. We want to do that. Want to mention to you that Friday at 10 a.m. we have that Word Bible study. Jesse Schaefer's doing that, and we're still in the book of Judges, so I'd encourage you to come out. That's a good teaching. Then we have, that's the Bible study, but we have the revival prayer. And revival prayer is at 11 a.m. We pray for our government, whether active or inactive, and we also pray for the representatives and senators and judges and our president, each and every one of them, and we'll pray for the lost as well. So come on at 11 a.m. and pray with us as well. Saturday, they were having the oil painting. So you want to come out to the oil painting. It's at 9 o'clock at the pavilion. It's a good opportunity to be learn how to do some oil painting. Sunday at 10 a.m., we have our church service. Come on out 10 a.m. on Sunday and enjoy our presence with God. And the puppet tents are still outside from kids from the ages 4 to 6. And then don't forget, we also have the passageway And the Paradise Kids between the ages of 7 and up. So that'd be a good thing. And don't forget our second service is at 11:15, right out in the pavilion. There's a lot of fresh air out there. There's a lot of separation out there. So come on out. Let's all stand up and praise God tonight. Let's give some glory to God for who He is. We're thankful that He's God and we're not. Hallelujah. Father, we're going to bless you and give you praise tonight and give you thanks for who you are. And thank you for loving us. Thank you for loving us, Father. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
I'm leaning on the everlasting arms that placed me on the rock that stands. And I hold true to the one who breaks my fall and lifts me time and time again. Oh my God, you're so good. You never give up. You never give up on me. Oh, what joy I found because of your love, because of your love for me. Oh my God, you're so good. You never give up, never give up on me. Oh, what joy I found because of your love, because of your love for me. Hey! This freedom. This freedom purchased by the highest price. This grace outweighing all my shame. And I'm made new through the power of sacrifice. From death now raised to life again. Oh my God, you're so good. You never give up. You never give up on me. Oh, what joy I found because of your love, because of your love for me. Oh my God, you're so good, you never give up, you never give up on me. Oh, what joy I found because of your love, because of your love for me.
Sing us out, I'm not a slave. I'm not a slave to sin, so I'm singing, you are good. I was buried with Christ to rise in your freedom. You are good, cause when you make a promise, Jesus, you keep it. You are good, so I praise your name as long as I'm breathing. You are good. I'm not a slave to sin, so I'm singing, you are good. Buried with Christ to rise in your freedom. You are good, you're always. You make a promise, Jesus, you keep it. Cause you are good. I praise your name as long as I'm breathing. You are good, yeah. Oh my God, you're so good. You never give up. You never give up on me. Oh, what joy I found because of your love. Because of your love for me. Oh my God, you're so good.
Never give up on me.
Oh, what joy I found. Oh my God, you're so good. You never give up. You never give up on me. Oh, what joy I found. Because of your love. Because of you. One more time. Oh my God, you're so good. You never give up. You never give up on me. Oh, what joy I found because of your love, because of your love. I'm not a slave to sin, so I'm singing. You are good. Buried with Christ to rise in your freedom. You are good. Cause you make a promise, Jesus, you keep it. Because you are good, Lord. I'll praise your name as long as I'm breathing. Because you're good. So, so good all the time. You are good, so, so good, so, so good.
We declare tonight you are good. Lord, there's some things you can't do, and that is be bad. So we thank you, Lord, that you are a good God tonight. And we just rest in that fact tonight. Only good things come from your hand, in Jesus' name. Your blood speaks a better word. Your love speaks a better word. Your blood speaks a better word. Your love speaks a better word. Your blood speaks a better word. Your love speaks a better word. Your blood speaks a better word. Your love speaks a better word. There's therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Where are your accusers now? Where are your accusers now? There's therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Where are your accusers now? Where, with the mighty hand and an outstretched arm, you are the God who saves. Deliver your name with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm. You are the God who saves. Deliver your name. Your blood, your blood. Your blood speaks a better word. Your love speaks a better word. Your blood speaks a better word. Your love speaks a better word. Your blood speaks a better word. Your love speaks a better word. Your blood speaks a better word. Your love speaks a better word. There's therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Where are your accusers now? Where are your accusers now? There's therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Where are your accusers now? Where, with the mighty hand and an outstretched arm, you are the God who saves. Deliver your name. With the mighty hand and an outstretched arm, you are the God who saves. Deliver your name. You put a ring. The ring upon my finger, you put your robe upon my back, you throw your arms around me and say, you are my son, my daughter, don't forget. You put the ring upon my finger, you put the robe upon my back, you throw your arms around me and say, you are my son, my daughter, don't forget. You put the ring upon my finger, you put the robe upon my back, you throw your arms around me and say, you are my son, my daughter, don't forget. You put the ring upon my finger, you put the robe upon my back, you throw your arms around me and say, you are my son, with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm. You are the God who says, deliver your name, with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm. You are the God who saves. Deliver. Let's declare this this evening. Salvation belongs to the Lord. Salvation belongs to the Lord. Salvation belongs to the Lord. Sing it again, sing it again. Salvation belongs to, belongs to you, Lord. Belongs to the Lord. Salvation belongs to the Lord. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Salvation belongs to the Lord. Salvation belongs to the Lord. Salvation belongs to the Lord. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Salvation belongs to the Lord. Salvation belongs to the Lord. Yeah. Deliver your name with the mighty. Belongs to the Lord.
belongs to the Lord. Salvation belongs to the Lord. It belongs to you, Lord. There is no other. You are the way, Lord. Jesus.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love. Dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good father. To you are, to you are, to you are, and I'm loved by you. To you I am. To who I am, to who I am. Oh, I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide, you know just what we need before we could say a word. You're a good, good father. To you are, to you are, to you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. You are perfect. You are perfect in all of your ways, Lord. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. To us. You are perfect in all of your ways, Lord. You're perfect in all of your ways. Perfect in all of your ways to love. Love so undeniable, I can hardly speak. Peace so unexplainable, I can hardly think as you call me, deeper still as you call me, deeper still as you call me, deeper still in love, love. You're a good, good father. To you are, to you are, to you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. You're a good, good, good father. It's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am.
Let's make this a prayer tonight. I'm giving you my heart. I'm
all that is within. Lay it all down for the sake of you, my King. I'm giving you my dreams. I'm laying down my rights. I'm giving up my pride for the promise of new life. And I surrender all to you, all to you. And I surrender all to you, all to you.
I'm singing you this song tonight, God.
Singing you this song. I'm waiting at the cross, and all the world holds dear. I count it all as loss for the sake of knowing you, the glory of your name, to know the lasting joy, even sharing in your pain.
Surrender all to you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. God, we do surrender to you right now. Thank you, Lord. We take up our cross and follow you. Thank you, Lord. We're going to deny ourselves and look to you, Lord, to supply all of our need according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Thank you, Father, for your presence in this place. And Lord, every person that's listening right now online, we ask, God, that you touch them right where they are, that they might sense your presence right in their rooms, in their living rooms, wherever they are, Father, right now. And Lord, that you'll engulf them with your glory, your presence. Thank you, Lord, that they'll be restored in every way, made whole again, Father. Because Jesus, you came to reverse the curse. You came to set us free by your precious blood. Thank you, God. Touch them right now, we pray in Jesus' name. In fact, all of you, let's just pray this prayer together right now. Say it right out loud. Heavenly Father, say it right out loud. Heavenly Father, I believe with all my heart Jesus is the Son of God. Oh, thank you for dying for my sins. Thank you for being raised from the dead with resurrection power for every person. Thank you for forgiving me, making me brand new, giving me a brand new start, a new identity, a new image, a new mentality, and a new destiny. Thank you for doing it, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, if you prayed that prayer in a minute, I wanted you to know that you're a child of God today because of the free gift of salvation. The Bible says the wages of sin are death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So receive that free gift tonight. It's all yours because you believed in your heart and you expressed it with your mouth, and because Jesus then has paid the price. Amen. Glory to God. Well, how many love him tonight? Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. He never gives up on us. I mean, he's not giving up on the Pirates either. Even though they lost today, I figured I'd wear this shirt. Maybe that'll help him out a little bit. I don't know. So pray for him. What, a 6-19, I think, something like that. Father, we do thank you for the Pirates. Keep him safe, Father. Keep him healthy in Jesus' name. Give someone else a virtual fist bump there and tell them Jesus loves you. Glory to God. Hey, 1 week from tonight, we want to have just a brief advisory council meeting. It's that time of month again, we have our advisory council leadership meeting. So 1 week from tonight, be sure to come out, advisory council people, and we'll meet. All right, are you ready to give tonight? What a wonderful privilege it is to give to the Lord, you know? And God says he loves cheerful givers, so I'm happy to give tonight, aren't you? Because I know when I sow that there's going to be a return on my giving. Absolutely. Everything that you invest in the kingdom, you know, the Bible talks about us laying up on our account or in our account in heaven. It's like God knows all about that. And as you sow in your account in heaven, then there might come a time when you need to draw on that account. Isn't that right? Praise God. So just like your checking account, you draw on it because there's something in there. Okay. Well, that's what we're doing tonight, putting something in our heavenly account. And how many know it's much better than some corporation or some stock or bond that you could buy? Absolutely, because God guarantees return on this. He says in Luke 6:38, if you give, it's going to be given unto you. What? Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Glory to God. So let's do that tonight. Ushers, anybody needs an envelope for your giving, though, go ahead and put your hand up. And we're just going to be happy about our giving tonight. Anybody at all need an envelope? There you go. Good to see you.
Praise God.
Oh, we had a wonderful picnic here on Sunday. Lots of people ministered to. Praise God. God is good. And I think this is the last class for Kathy Work this coming Sunday, right after church. Last one for a while. So be sure to come out for that. Let's go ahead and give tonight. Brother James, you want to come up? All right, let's prepare to give. Amen. Thank you, Lord. How about you praying, brother?
Yeah, Lord, we just thank you for these tithes and offerings. We ask you to use it for your glory and to spread the good news of the gospel. Bless the gift giver alike. In Jesus' name, amen.
Anybody not feeling well tonight? Anybody at all? You're not? We're going to pray for you, right? Anybody else not feeling well tonight? Let's just take a minute and pray for this brother. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, thank you right now for Brian. Father, we ask that your hand be upon his life right now, God, that you just allow him to receive the anointing of the Holy Spirit, Father. Bring healing and restoration from the top of his head to the soles of his feet. Father, that he can enjoy this time of refreshing in the presence of the Lord. God, that he can imbibe your word and experience a rest and a refreshing that comes through you, through the Holy Spirit. Thank you for healing every facet of his being, every cell, every tissue. Line up right now with the word of God in Jesus' name. And Father, thank you for making him whole, complete in you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Yeah, let's praise him.
I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop, yeah, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. Cause you are a way maker, miracle worker, the promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. That is who you are. The way maker, the miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. Jesus, that is who you are. 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 That
That is who you are. 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 You're the way maker, the miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. Waymaker, the miracle worker, the promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Well, he is the miracle worker, the waymaker. And in this last day, the Holy Spirit needs to have our attention. You know, many people are not finishing strong because they're not giving place to the ministry of the Holy Spirit. The Word is important, but the Holy Spirit is too. And so we don't want to social distance the Holy Ghost. Amen. Hallelujah. We want to draw close to Him. He's the one, because Jesus was the representative of God on the earth when He was here around the shores of Galilee. But then He ascended to heaven and He left the Holy Spirit. He said, it's more expedient for you that I go, for if I don't go, the Comforter won't come. And so the Holy Spirit came, and now He, the Holy Spirit, is the representative of the Godhead on this earth now. And His ministry is to do what? To perform miracles. To convince people of Jesus. That word convict there in John, I think it's 16, means to convince people about Jesus. But you see, one of the ways He convinces them is with signs and wonders. What do signs do? They point the way, don't they? Sign at the bottom of the hill says, we're a live church up the hill, right? It's a sign to point the way. And see, that's what signs and wonders do. Miracles will point the way and say, Jesus is alive on planet Earth. And you know, when I was filled with the Holy Ghost, Jesus became more real to me when I was filled with the Spirit. Do you know that? He became ever so more real. The Word of God began to jump off the page. And before that, there was a lot of revelation that I needed. And I wasn't getting it. It was just like reading a comic book or something. But when I got filled with the Holy Ghost, now this Word came alive. Glory to God. You gotta be seated. And the Holy Spirit is something else, you know? And what an awesome blessing and privilege it is to be able to pray in the Spirit. You know, when I was first filled with the Holy Spirit, I did not speak in tongues. And it was a while. Why? Because of ignorance. I needed some teachings, that's all. I just needed to know that it's in the Bible, 1 Corinthians chapter 14. And so the Holy Spirit is there as the comforter, the helper, the standby, the advocate, the counselor, the one that's called alongside to help. Oh, aren't you glad for the Holy Spirit? And in this last day, we are going to need the Holy Spirit in order to be successful, in order to finish strong in this last day. I'm so glad that I'm filled with the Spirit. But you know, I got to hanging around with some charismatic Catholic people.
Yes, you did.
And man, it just kind of rubbed off on me. And I saw the gifts of the Spirit functioning. And I said, yeah, I got to have that. I don't want, if there's anything more, I want it. I don't want to hold back on anything. Because, see, God's a God of miracles, and you can see miracles as the gifts of the Spirit begin to function. So, the Holy Spirit is a person. And He is the Spirit of truth. And that's why when I opened my Bible, you see, the truth came jumping off the page. Because He's the Spirit of truth. And He's the teacher of the church. And so what happened through revelation knowledge then that I was getting from the Word? It set me free. The more learning you get, the better. Because He says, if you continue in my Word, then are you my disciples indeed. And you'll know this truth. And what's going to happen? The truth will make you free.
Amen.
I was bound up. I was inadequate. I was just a mess. I couldn't talk to anybody. I was an introvert. I'd start to get red from here up. My wife was an extrovert. I was an introvert. Well, she helped me, but the Holy Spirit helped me too. Because He gives you boldness. When you think about Peter, Think about Peter for a moment. Here's Peter who denied Jesus three times. Peter cussed. I don't know exactly what he cussed, but he cussed when he was confronted. Do you know Jesus? And he cussed, and he denied Jesus three times. And then, can you imagine Peter? Later, he probably thought, oh, I'm such a failure. I denied Jesus one time, and then, my goodness, I turned around and I did it a second time. Oh, what a failure I am. And then I denied him a third time, three times, and oh, I'm such a failure. But God said, and by the way, Peter was such a mess. He was probably a candidate for a minister's rehab conference or rehab center or something, wasn't he? When you think about it. Yet God says, no, Peter, I want you to preach on the day of Pentecost. I'm calling you to preach.
Who, me?
Yeah. And what happened? Peter was filled with the Holy Ghost. And something happened to Peter. He was changed forever. Glory to God. He went from being a coward to a courageous proponent of the gospel, preached the good news of the gospel, and people got saved. 3,000 people got born again. And then there was a miracle of the lame man, you know, at the gate beautiful. And Peter and John came, and the man was asking for alms, and Peter said, well, silver and gold have I none, but whatever I have, I'm going to give it to you. And here it is. Rise up and walk. And the man got up. Miracle took place. He went walking and leaping and praising God, went into the temple, and guess what? 5,000 more people got born again. 8,000 total, because God empowered Peter with the baptism in the Holy Spirit. Oh, glory to God. I'm telling you, when you get filled with the Holy Spirit, there's a freedom that comes. A freedom in your worship, a freedom in your expression, a freedom in your boldness to share Jesus with people. A freedom. Because the Bible says where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is what? Freedom. Now, I didn't know I was going to say all this tonight. But I love the Holy Spirit. Somebody asked me one time, did you ever see the Holy Spirit? No, I've never seen him. But I sure have felt him. I sure have noticed his presence, felt his presence. Was that 1 Chronicles? Take a look at 1 Chronicles 15. I think that's what it is. 1 Chronicles chapter 15. Yeah. In verse 1, it says, and David, 1 Chronicles 15, 1, and David made him houses in the city of David and prepared a place for the ark of God. He prepared a place for the ark of God and pitched for it a tent. David prepared a place for the presence of God. That's what you and I are doing. When we get filled with the Holy Spirit, something happens. We become a habitation of the Spirit. And there is a place, a tent, a tabernacle, if you will, that's prepared for His presence. Amen. And you carry His presence with you. And miracles take place. I just saw a picture of a little girl. Her down in the Southwest, it was sent to me. She got bitten twice by a rattlesnake. And man, she was in bad shape. And they got people to praying. How many believe there's power in prayer? Well, I just got the word today. The little girl is going to make it. She's fine. But man, they showed pictures of her legs. Yeah, all kind of crazy stuff the way it looks, but hey, she's healed. She's going to make it. Amen. Hallelujah. And so that gives us reason to rejoice. And so the Holy Spirit is there to help us to rejoice because of the miraculous power of God. And, you know, I was going to preach on how to stay strong through this corona thing and how to finish strong. That's what I've preached on Sunday, how to finish strong. And in Luke chapter 18 and verse 1. Let's look there. Luke 18:1. The Holy Spirit is there to help us to finish strong. God doesn't want you to finish weak, emaciated, downtrodden, disheartened, despondent, or anything else. And in the Luke, oh, I got Acts 18. Let me see. Luke 18 and verse 8. You got anything, Matt, to share? A couple things? Okay. Luke 18, 8 and verse 1. No, verse 8 says, let's go to 18, 8. It says, well, no, let's start at 1. That's good. My wife's encouraging me here. And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. Saying, there was in a city a judge which feared not God, neither rewarded man, nor regarded man, excuse me. Saying, okay, and there was a widow in that city, and she came unto him, saying, avenge me of mine adversary. And he would not for a while, but afterward he said within himself, though I fear not God, nor regard man, yet because this widow troubleth me, I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary me. In other words, here's an unjust judge, and this woman keeps bugging him, keeps asking, keeps petitioning, keeps requesting, and he said, finally, I've had it up to here. I'm going to answer her prayer. I'm going to answer her request. And the Lord said, hear what the unjust judge saith, and shall not God avenge... Now, God's not an unjust judge. But he said, if an unjust judge would do this, how much more would God do? And he says, and shall not God avenge his own elect? Now, the word elect here is referring to Christians. Now, there's other places in the Bible the word elect refers to the Jews. But here it's referring to believers. And shall not God avenge his own elect, the people in Christ, which cried day and night unto him, though he bear long with them. I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, shall he find faith on the earth? He's talking about intercessory prayer here. He's talking about, will he not avenge me, be avenged speedily, those who cry day and night? Crying day and night, that sounds like intercessory prayer. It's not the prayer of faith where you pray one time and believe that you receive it, right? But they're crying day and night, so that's got to be intercessory prayer. And he says, won't I avenge them speedily because they cry day and night? Then he goes on, nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, in the NLT version it says, when the Son of Man returns, Jesus is coming back. When the Son of Man returns, shall he find faith on the earth? Is he going to find anybody with some faith? Anybody with some passion, anybody with some drive, anybody with some fervor, anybody with some zeal, anybody with a hunger for God's word, anybody who loves the Holy Ghost, anybody who's filled and staying full. Glory to God. The Passion Bible says it this way. When I return, will I find persistent faithfulness in his people? Will I find persistent faithfulness in his people? Yeah. If we allow the Holy Spirit to strengthen us. He's the strengthener. He's the standby. If we allow the Holy Spirit. Church, I'm telling you, the key to the last day, staying on top of things, being an overcomer, winning, being strong, and finishing strong, is the Holy Ghost. Amen. The Holy Spirit will keep you strong. Glory to God. I'm having fun. So don't social distance the Holy Ghost. All right? Don't allow life's tribulations squeeze it out of you, or the hurts of life to disengage you, or allow the chaos of the world to rob them of their firm persuasion. And that's what faith is. Faith is a firm persuasion. Do you want a definition of faith? There it is. Faith is a firm persuasion. You're persuaded about what? That what God said, what God promised, he is also able to perform. Glory to God. That's what he told Abraham. You're going to have a son, many sons. And Abraham, it says in Romans chapter 4, was fully persuaded that what God said, he is also able to perform. Trusting in his reliability, his dependability, his faithfulness, that he's going to bring it to pass. A firm persuasion. Will he find a firm persuasion in people? Many pastors, do you know, have resigned during this corona chaos, during these shutdowns? Yeah. Just could say, that's enough. That's it. I can't handle this anymore. You know, the suicide rate's up with teenagers 600%. Well, we must not allow fear to take over or to dominate us. We got to hold fast our profession of faith without wavering, right? Oh, don't cast away, therefore, your fearless confidence, the Bible says, which has a great recompense of reward. Do you believe it tonight? Glory to God. In fact, turn with me to 1 Timothy. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 18. 1 Timothy 1, 18 and 19. 1 Timothy 1, 18 says, "This charge I commit unto thee, son Timothy, according to the prophecies which went before on thee, that thou by them mightest war a good warfare." Timothy, you're warring a good warfare. Do you know when you're praying, and particularly praying in the Spirit, do you know that adds a new dimension to your prayer life when you're praying in the Holy Ghost? It talks about praying in Ephesians 6:18. We're to pray for all saints. How? In the Spirit. What does "in the Spirit" mean? Well, you look back in 1 Corinthians 14, and it says, "Howbeit in the Spirit we speak mysteries," when we're speaking in tongues, when we're praying in tongues. We're speaking mysteries in the Spirit. So, both kinds of prayer. It says all manner of prayer. So that means English and tongues. We're to be praying. But it'll take you to a new level, a new dimension in your prayer life when you're able to pray, and you'll be able to war a good warfare. Verse 19, holding faith and a good conscience, which some having put away concerning faith have made shipwreck. Some have put away what? A good conscience, put away faith, put away clean living, pure living, and just abandoned the faith and said, forget it. What happened? They became shipwrecked. Man, believe me, the latter end is worse than you know, whatever they had to endure. Believe me. And so we don't want to become shipwrecked and lose our morals, our convictions, our belief in Jesus. We want to hold faith in a good conversation. Paul said some of these have put them away, put it away. The result was they became shipwrecked. And see, the Holy Spirit will enable you to rise above what's going on. Do you know, listen, we've had a lot of negatives since January, haven't we? We've had a lot, you know, chaos in the cities and corona, bologna, and all this stuff, right? But you know what? Every time in my 41 years of pastoring that I've seen a bunch of garbage and negative and chaos and all this stuff, it always was followed by something good, a breakthrough, a miracle, some kind of a turnaround. Amen. Yeah. Every single time, I can tell you. So, church, this has been about 6-7 months now. This negative, get ready. We're going to have a good turnaround. Amen. We're going to have a good breakthrough. Glory to God. The Holy Ghost is going to give it to us. Woo! Glory to God. I hope that thing can follow me. So we're going to be able to rise above it. See, walk by faith and not by sight. I was telling them how when I flew airplanes, there's such an analogy. This in the second service, I told them such an analogy between flying on instruments and the Christian life. So much of an analogy between listening to the air traffic controller and listening to the Holy Spirit. Flew airplanes for 46 years, and sometimes I fly instruments and fly into the clouds or make an approach in the clouds. And what you have to do is you have to trust the instruments, just like you have to trust the Word of God. And even if you feel like you're, you know, the instruments say you're straight and level, but your voter goes telling you that you're sideways like this, and you got to say, shut up. vertigo. This is what the instrument says. I'm straight and level. See? You got to trust the word of God like you trust the instrument panel, not your feelings. How many know your feelings can lead you down a wrong road? Feelings have caused more problems in people's lives following feelings. Well, I had this feeling, and Daddy, I just love this guy, and I have this. How many know it may feel right, but it may not be right? Come on.
Amen.
Something may feel right, but it's not right. Oh, yeah, Daddy, it feels, I mean, this relationship, it feels right. I know, Daddy, he's a drug addict, and he's a pimp, and he carries a 9mm, and he sells drugs, and he cusses, and everything, but it just feels right. Honey, you better run fast.
Amen.
You better walk by faith and not by sight and believe what the Word of God says, see?
Amen.
So we walk, so in shooting an approach, when you're in the clouds, you know, you've got to trust the instruments. You can't not trust, as they say, flying by the seat of your pants. You can't trust your feelings. And then the air traffic controller, you're talking to him, and he's telling you, Cessna 37 Mike Tango, turn right, heading 320, climb and maintain 8,000, squawk 2715 on your transponder. Okay? You got to repeat all that back to him, by the way. You got to remember it and repeat it all back. But the air traffic controller is telling you to turn to heading 320 because he wants you to avoid running into an airliner that you can't see in the clouds. Yes, sir, I'll do it. And so who's the air traffic controller in your life? The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the one that will tell you, turn to heading 210, and you will avoid the worst collision that you've ever made in your life. And you will fly, and you will ride upon the high places of life, and you're going to win, and you're going to succeed because I'm guiding you. I am the Spirit of Truth. I'm your helper. I'm your strengthener. I'm your standby, and you're going to make it because of me, says the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And so we've got to trust. I mean, that's, you know, I was in the clouds one time when I was a student with a guy. And I said to him, gee, you can't see anything. And you're listening to this, they call them vectors, giving you vectors. You know, turn left heading 220 or something. Those are vectors. Well, the Holy Spirit will give you vectors, see. I said to him, what if you ran into an airliner? He says, well, you just bought the farm. That's what he said. So always remember that. I don't want to buy, you know. Yeah, right. So follow the vectors that the Holy Spirit gives you, see. Because you will always break out of those clouds with a 5,000-foot runway right in front of you. Glory to God.
Yeah.
And you can get out of the plane and kiss the ground, whatever you want to do. But following the Holy Spirit, you see, will get you through every dilemma, through this situation, the corona. I tell you, something good is about to happen, church. I'm telling you right now, it's going to happen. God is on the move. Because there's been so much craziness, get ready. Something good is about to happen.
Amen.
Amen. Why? What are we doing? We're making a tent for His presence. For the Holy Spirit's presence. Right here. The temple of the Holy Spirit. Oh, man, come on. You got a couple things to share. It's how we stand strong.
Yeah, so talking about finishing strong, we want to finish this service strong. So if you look at any dollar bill, still in America, you'll see a special phrase on the back of it. Has anybody ever heard this before? It says, "In God we trust." On the back of the $1 bill. And you know, it's very true that if you put your trust in the government right now, you put your trust in a stimulus check or an unemployment check or put your trust in anything else other than God, guess what? It's not worthy of your trust. I want to close out the service with a verse. If you want to turn there, Psalm 62, verse 2. I want to just read this out of the Young's Literal Translation. It says, this is the Psalm of David. The verse 1 says, "Only towards God is my soul silent. From Him is my salvation. So we can just rest in knowing that He is on our side. Like Pastor was saying, your brain's telling you to turn this way to stay level, but really, if you do that, you're going to wreck. So you have to go against reasoning, and you have to move into a position of trust. This nurse, whenever I was born, actually disobeyed the doctors and took me out of this special breathing isolate against the doctors. Can you imagine today? The doctor coming in the next day, why did you do this? She could have got fired, but she went against her reasoning, ignored the vertigo or whatever, and she did what she heard the Lord tell her, and she put me in a regular crib, whatever they put babies in, that don't need special oxygen, because the Lord told her to. And her obedience, I woke up, or they came to see me the next morning, and both of my lungs were working.
Yes.
Whereas opposed to the night before, the day before, they were not working. And they were calling me Burr Reynolds, like Burt Reynolds, because I was quivering, trying to breathe. So anyways, you cannot lean on your own understanding. When it sounds crazy, it's probably God. Oh, man. So verse 2 says, only He is my rock. As long as it lines up with Scripture. Only He is my rock. And my salvation, my tower, I am not much moved. I'm going to say that again. Only He is my rock. And my salvation, my tower, I am not much moved. Let's look down at verse 5. Only for God be silent, O my soul, for from Him is my hope. Verse 6. Only He is my rock. And my salvation, my tower. Again, he says it, I am not moved. In verse 7, on God is my salvation and my honor. The rock of my strength, my refuge is in God. So I just want to leave tonight remembering that our trust is not in man. Our trust and our hope is not in a mask. Our hope is in the Lord. He is worthy, and it goes beyond human reasoning, human understanding. You mean I can wake up happy in the midst of all this? Yes, you can. You can wake up excited in the midst of all this? Yes, you can. You know that I've been reading this book on potential. You have unlimited. If God is in you, and He did all of this, can you imagine all the millions and billions of stars, all the galaxies? That's the guy we serve, the guy who did all that. And He's in us. I would not lean on an education, on a degree. I would lean on the Holy Spirit in you who knows everything. And as Pastor was saying, as we hook up and we spend time with Him and we listen to His voice and we earnestly seek Him, you will get downloads on how to not only just survive but to excel. We were reading this book, and I started describing a dream I have to do something, and my wife said, write that down. Because sometimes when we're just maybe just talking, that's actually God speaking through us, potential. So what makes it come alive is actually doing it. So let God's breathed potential become alive in you. Write it down, pray over it. If it costs millions of dollars, just keep praying over it. And if it's for the kingdom, He'll provide it. So He alone is our salvation. He's our rock, our strength. When we feel weak, when we feel like just staying in bed, we say, Lord, strengthen me. Lord, help me to have the strength to drive the kids to school every day this year and not get weary and well-doing. And we lean into Him. I love what Joyce Meyer says about enjoying every day. Don't let the years pass you by and you're miserable and you're waiting for that something to come to make you happy, because it'll never come. If you know the Lord, that's all you need to know. In Him there's fullness of joy. And at His right hand are pleasures forevermore. So in God we trust. Say it with me. In God we trust. Amen.
Glory to God.
Thank you, son. Hey, just one P.S. That was good. How do you train to fly an instrument? You see these glasses? They're all fogged up, except for this little area right here. These glasses are called foggles. So you put these on with an instructor sitting beside you, and you fly because with looking at the instruments, you can't see out of the airplane with these on. All you can see is the instrument panel. So you're trained, it's kind of like blinders, you're trained to focus on those instruments and nothing else. And see, God will train us, it's kind of like we've got to put the blinders on to the craziness and all the things that are going on in the world and say, no, I'm going to focus on God's word. That's the thing that's reliable, dependable. I'm going to put my foggles on, okay? Hallelujah. Let's stand tonight. I had a good time tonight. How about you? Hallelujah. I enjoyed running. That was a good exercise. Glory to God. Good to have my friend Cameron back here. Met him recently. Good to have you. Come on, let's welcome Cameron back here. Glory to God. Father, thank you so much for your goodness. Father, thank you that we have this wonderful relationship with you, Lord, that we can come to you and you can speak to us and direct us. Give us Holy Ghost vectors, Father, to lead us into the good life. Father, thank you just as you spared me for 46 years flying. You kept me and my wife too. Father, you will keep us and give us long life. Father, thank you today that we're going to trust in your word. We're going to trust in the Holy Spirit, the paraclete, the one that's called alongside to help, and so that we can finish strong in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. We love you. Have a great evening.